ओके, सो वी हैव सीन हाउ हर्मिशियन ऑपरेटर्स एंड यूनिटरी ऑपरेटर्स बोथ दीज क्लासेस ऑफ ऑपरेटर्स यू नो यील्ड दिस सेकंड रिजल्ट करस्पॉन्डिंग टू ईच ऑफ दीज विच इज दैट आइगन वैक्टर्स ऑफ डिस्टिंक्ट आइगन वैल्यूज हैव टू बी ऑर्थोगनल राइट सो दिस अ क्रूशियल प्रॉपर्टी सो यू कैन पुट टुगेदर अ बंच ऑफ ऑर्थोगनल आइगन वैक्टर्स एंड क्रिएट अ बेसिस एंड दैट्स गोइंग टू स्पैन द होल स्पेस राइट सो दैट्स यू नो इट्स of great importance. So this, you know, gives you matrices which are diagonalizable and so on, which we will come back to at a later time. So we might be interested in the question, you know, what is this, what is the most sort of general class of operators? So why should we force, you know, operators to be either Hermitian or unitary, or, you know, some conditions have to be imposed on operators. Not all operators satisfy this type of property. And so if we ask the question, what is this, what is the general condition that operators must satisfy such that you know this property, the second property, which is namely that any two eigenvectors corresponding to distinct eigenvalues are going to be orthogonal, it turns out that this kind of a class is called, you know, normal operators, which is a much, which is a bigger class of operators in which, you know, Hermitian operators and unitary operators are also part of this bigger class, right? So that's the topic of discussion for this lecture. Okay, so an operator is called normal if it commutes with its adjoint, right? N n dagger is equal to n dagger n, right? So this operation n times n dagger minus n dagger n is called the commutator, and if that commutator is zero, right, which is the same as saying n dagger is equal to n dagger n, then we say that such an operator is normal, right? You can immediately check that both unitary operators and Hermitian operators are normal operators, right? So Hermitian operators, clearly n dagger it's will going to be n itself, and n dagger will be n, so then n squared is of course equal to n squared, and the defining property of a unitary operator is u dagger is equal to u dagger u is equal to, you know, identity, right? So it turns out that you don't need this to be equal to identity. If you just manage to show that n dagger is equal to n dagger n, that's already enough, right? So this is a broader class of operators, you know, it's already enough as far as, you know, this property that we're going to prove is concerned, which is about the second property related to eigenvectors, right? If it also is equal to I, then we have seen that that's the class of unitary operators, and that gives you unimodularity for the eigenvalues. Let's look at you know, this result correct for eigenvectors of normal operators. But before we go there, there's one more result which we can prove for normal operators. If n is a normal operator and x is an eigenvector of n with eigenvalue lambda, then x is an eigenvector also of the operator n dagger and with eigenvalue lambda star, right? So we are given n acting on x is equal to lambda x. So we want to argue that in fact x is an eigenvector also of another operator, which is the adjoint of n, and whose eigenvalue is also something we can work out, and that's going to be lambda star, right? How do we see this? So the argument is actually quite clever, right? So we already have a priori knowledge of this lambda star being an eigenvalue of n dagger and with whose eigenvector is also known. So let's just simply consider this vector y. N dagger, you know, is an operator, and x is a vector, so n dagger acting on x is a vector, and we have the freedom to form another vector, which is, you know, subtracting minus lambda star acting on this vector x. So now we will show that this is in fact the zero vector, right? So how do we do this? We just simply compute the inner product of this vector y with itself. If you do this carefully, then you see that, you know, you get four terms, right? So the first term is x acting on n dagger x, right? So this is something that you should convince yourself, right? So if you take the bra vector corresponding to n dagger x, that's going to give you x n,
then you have n dagger x, then you have a minus lambda star x. So I have taken the the bra vector corresponding to this x n, then x, then you have a minus lambda x n dagger x plus lambda lambda star x x, right? So there are four terms, and then you see that two of them immediately simplify. So you have x n dagger x. So I'm using the normal vector property. So n n dagger is the same as n dagger n. So I have the freedom to change the order. Then I have minus lambda star. So n acting on x is just lambda times x. So that's the eigenvalue equation. Then I have minus lambda x n dagger x. I just leave this as it is, plus lambda lambda star x x. Then, but again, n acting on x is lambda x. So this n dagger x will give me lambda star. So I have lambda star in the product of x with x, minus, again, this lambda will come out, lambda star in the product of x with x. Then I leave these last two terms as it is. So you see that the first two terms get cancelled. So this will go away to zero, these two terms. So then you're just left with lambda star xx minus lambda times this matrix element x n dagger x. So now we will use this property of we'll take the dual of this normal vector nx. So we have x n dagger is equal to lambda star x, right? So then that's equation 2. So then we further simplifies to inner product of yy is lambda star xx minus. So then I am bringing the ket vector here from the right side. So x n dagger x is equal to lambda star xx. So I have minus lambda star xx. But both these terms are the same, and there's a negative sign here. So inner product of y with y is 0. So what we have managed to show is that this is basically the zero vector. Y is a zero vector because there is only one vector whose inner product with itself is zero, right? And that is the zero vector. And that immediately means that n dagger acting on x is equal to lambda star x, which is what we set out to prove, right? So x is, if x is an eigenvector of n with eigenvalue lambda, it implies that x is also an eigenvector of n dagger, but with eigenvalue lambda star. And we will use this result to prove the main result, which we are after, which is that eigenvectors of a normal vector corresponding to distinct eigenvalues are orthogonal, right? So let's consider two eigenvectors x1 and x2 with distinct eigenvalues lambda 1 and lambda 2, right? So you have n acting on x1 is lambda 1 x1, and n acting on x2 is lambda 2 x2. So if you take the inner product from the left with x1, right, we have x1 for the second equation, right, we have x1 n x2 is equal to lambda 2 x1 x2. But we have also seen that, you know, from this equation 3 implies n dagger x1 is equal to lambda 1 star x1, right, because x1 is an eigenvector of n with eigenvalue lambda 1, x1 is also an eigenvector of n dagger but with eigenvalue lambda 1 star. So now if I take the dual of this equation, I have x1 bra x1 n is equal to lambda 1 bra vector x1, and then I can bring in the ket vector x2 from the right hand side, x2 ket from the right hand side, I have x1 n x2 is equal to lambda 1 x1 x2. So if I look at equations 4 and 5, I have managed to compute this matrix element x1 n x2 in two different ways, and I have found that one of them is lambda 2 times x1 x2, the other one is lambda 1 times x1 x2. If I subtract these two, I get lambda 1 minus lambda 2 times x1 x2 is equal to 0, the inner product of x1 x2 is equal to 0. And the only way this is possible, since we have taken lambda 1 and lambda 2 to be distinct, is if the inner product of x1 and x2 itself is 0. That's proving the orthogonality of two eigenvectors with distinct eigenvalues, right? So this is a general result. We could have started from this and then argued that both Hermitian operators and unitary operators are normal operators, and therefore this result holds in each of these cases. But it is instructive to individually apply the properties of each of these kinds of operators and then
you know, generalize. And a consequence of this property is that all normal operators are, you know, diagonalizable when we go to matrices. So we will, discuss, just like we have Hermitian operators, there are Hermitian matrices, there are unitary matrices, there are normal matrices, and so on, right? If you have an n by n normal matrix, so we will argue later on that such matrices are diagonalizable, which means that they have a, you know, as many eigenvectors as as many linearly independent eigenvectors as the size of the matrix, and in fact they can span the whole space, right? So this is an idea which is best illustrated with examples that we will do in the course of, you know, lectures that will follow. At this point, I just want to point out that all the results we have shown so far apply, you know, to general linear operators, right? For a general linear vector space, right? So later on we will specialize to matrices and, you know, look at some of these consequences, right? That's all for this lecture. Thank you.